At the same time, Kenya and Tanzania have agreed to build a gas pipeline from Dar es Salaam to lower energy costs in the country. It was one of the several agreements reached during bilateral talks between delegations led by President Uhuru Kenyatta and Samia Suluhu Hassan. As Dennis Otieno reports, the very business nature of the first day of President Suluhu's visit and her planned meetings with the business community on the second day of her visit indicates a leader focused on strengthening her country's economy.
The deal on a gas pipeline from Dar es Salaam to Mombasa confirms that Kenya is planning to import gas from its East African community neighbor. The signing of a memorandum of understanding underlining the decision as the two countries seek to open a new page in what has been a tumultuous relationship.
Stima na energy ambaye ni environmentally friendly katika taifa letu la Kenya.
President Suluhu, who in one of her very first speeches in office as head of state in Tanzania, asked government officials and especially her revenue collection authority to ensure they facilitated a conducive business environment in the country, focusing on similar cross-border obstacles.
Lakini kwa lengo la kukuza biashara pia na uwekezaji kati yetu tumekubaliana kuendelea kushughulikia baadhi ya changamoto hususan vikwazo visivyo vya kodi.
Kenya is currently Tanzania's top investor in the EAC region and the fifth in the continent, having implemented a total of 513 projects. On its part, Tanzania has also made inroads.
Zipo kampuni 30 za Tanzania ambazo zimewekeza mtaji ndani ya Kenya wenye thamani ya shilingi za Kenya bilioni 19,330,000 na kutoa ajira kwa watu 2,600 na kama 40 hivi.
Mkataba mwingine ambao tumeweka kidole wa kuhakikisha ya kwamba tumeimarisha uhusiano wetu kwa mambo ya culture, social integration, national heritage, ambaye tumeleta wananchi wetu pamoja.
The frosty trade relations between her nation and Kenya on her mind. The most recent illustration, recent news coverage on the denial of access to Tanzania for Kenyan truck drivers soon after trucks ferrying maize from Tanzania to Kenya were denied access to local markets. In 2020, COVID-19 had caused strain over testing and certification. President Suluhu pointing out that Tanzania was keen on addressing the trade imbalance that favors Kenya. In 2017, Tanzania imported goods worth 23.3 billion shillings, while exporting goods worth 23.7 billion shillings to Kenya.
Tanzania sasa tutakuja kwa nguvu yote Kenya, kuja kuwekeza ili kukuza ile ujazo wa biashara au volume of trade.
A matter that her host, President Uhuru Kenyatta, is keen on facilitating as part of measures to boost trade between the two nations. The two nations also agreed to improve connectivity through new roads, aviation, and maritime transport. Dennis Otieno, Citizen TV.